track down the third partner in that con game?
No, not yet. Black girl's given us a number of addresses and hangouts on him. She really wants to help herself.
You did good work on this tie-in.
What's James's plan?
Captain,
we need to talk.
On this cop's transfer, I need to tell you, I don't think it was your finest hour.
Why is that?
The both of us know the job has an ethical awareness course for this kind of cop in this kind of situation.
The sensitivity class isn't gonna do it for this guy.
Arthur, if Szymanski's like you say he is, don't like black people much to begin with, plus resentful now, from his point of view, a black boss lost his life up, is that the kind of cop you want walking around a neighborhood don't need any extra problems?
So you're concerned I'd be lowering the quality of life in Bed-Stuy?
I'm just pointing out what I know you know already. As bosses, our decisions have consequences outside the rooms we make them in.
If you want to discuss the quality of policing in black neighborhoods, we could take that up at length. But what's going on here is what always goes on with a black man on this job who asks for an accommodation. It's assumed he's got a hidden agenda.
Look, I came here asking for you to look at using your juice to hurt this guy and remind you that people neither you nor I know are liable to pay the tab. Pretending it's about you being black so you don't have to face what it is you're doing, that's on you.
Okay. Okay, transfer him to this precinct.
Transfer him here?
Yeah, that way I can deal every day with the consequences of the decisions we made here.
I think over time, knowing the kind of man you are at heart might turn out good for Szymanski. Might be good for you, too.
I think we've looked enough into my heart and soul, Captain. Is sending him here acceptable to you?
Yeah. I can make that happen.